from Tonkadale, and today I want to talk to you about some really great sun-loving perennials that pollinators just adore. Now, there are tons of perennials that are hardy in our area. Remember, we're a zone 4. In the winter, our temperatures can get down to about negative 30 degrees Fahrenheit. I picked out a few of my favorite pollinator plants for sun. A lot of these are later bloomers, so they're all gonna kind of put on a show at the same time. However, I did pick them because of the longevity of their blooms, so you get a lot of action for a long time. So let's start with my all-time favorite, echinacea. I love echinacea because there is a wide range of colors and heights. In my mind, the dark pink varieties tend to be a little bit more hardy, and there are a couple of native varieties native to Minnesota, and those are gonna give you a little bit better nectar and pollen quality. However, pollinators still love to come and land on these flowers. Think of these flat flower heads like a landing pad for a butterfly. They can really just, they're very light, and they can just sit there and land and drink up the nectar and collect pollen as they go from flower to flower. So these are echinacea. They start to bloom about mid-June, and their blooms last, I would say, for 4 to 6 weeks, depending on the variety. All right, guys, the next perennial I picked that pollinators just love is sedum. We all know sedum autumn joy. It's kind of the quintessential sedum, but there's a lot of variety throughout sedums in general, including low-growing sedums and kind of trailing and spreading sedums, ground cover sedums, ranging in bloom color from yellow to pinks and purples to really vibrant raspberries, light pink and almost cherry red. Sedums generally are clump forming, so this within 3 years I would imagine could be this big. So they do require some staking if they're larger, and if they start to get big and floppy in the middle where the center is kind of bare, that's when you know it's time to cut it back, divide it, and spread it out a bit. Anyway, the flowers on the sedum are big. They're kind of dome-shaped flowers, and they're great landing plants for butterflies and also big bees. Make sure to look for the different foliage colors. The foliage is really cool because you can have like dusty blues to purples to sagey greens, and I really like how that knocks up against just our regular greens in the garden. All right, here we go. Coming into the later months of summer, like July and August, you're gonna see monardas just blow up like fireworks. One of my favorite things to watch happening in the monarda patch are the hummingbirds. So the hummingbirds love that vibrant red color, and they just flit, what would you call it, flit and fly all through the monarda in the early morning hours. So look for different heights of monarda. The monarda that I have in my garden, it spreads like crazy. So you can let it spread, or you can tame it back just by pulling out the plant parts of the plant that you don't want, and it doesn't hurt it at all. Another pollinator favorite and a late season bloomer is Eupatorium, or Jopai weed. The original Jopai weed gets up to 5 or 6 feet tall, and they have just massive kind of dome-shaped flowers that butterflies and bees and pollinators just love. These varieties are dwarf varieties. This one's called Chocolate, and you can see that really dark, pretty foliage. It's gonna just get more glossy and more copper the more sun that it gets. And then this one's called Baby Joe. So these are gonna stay more compact, probably 2 to 3 feet tall. And these are great in the garden for pollinators and late season color. All right, last perennial we're gonna talk about today for pollinators is the Black-Eyed Susan, or Rudbeckia. There are several native Rudbeckias that you can grow if you have a bigger landscape or a really wild kind of prairie garden. Some of the cultivars here though are interesting because this one is called Early Bird Gold, and so that means it's gonna bloom a bit earlier than your traditional Goldstrom Rudbeckia, but it's still gonna be hardy in our zone, which is zone 4. So Rudbeckia, also known as Black-Eyed Susan, has that brown center and then a gold color flower, and I really like how the petals on this one curl down and they're kind of drippy looking. These are a great garden spreader. They kind of spread in clumps, and they're gonna start firing off blooms right around the same time as the echinacea and the monarda, so they make a really pretty show for, well, for us to look at, but also to attract the pollinators. When you're planting any of these pollinator favorites, you're gonna wanna plant them in clusters or in mass. The bigger the mass, the easier it is for them to see because they're attracted to the different colors of the flower. And so if you just have one of each, it's a little harder for them to zone in and visit the garden. But if you're able to plant 3, 4, 5, or 6, that's a great way to pull the pollinators into your garden. I get tingly when I say this, but one of my favorite things to do is to sit on my front porch and look out at my garden, because I really like to just kind of mix it up with herbs and vegetables, annuals and perennials, especially those that attract pollinators. And so in the morning, you can sit and drink coffee and look at the garden, and then in the evening, you know, the red wine, of course. And it's just so rewarding to watch those pollinators do their work. So I hope you enjoyed our video today, and we'll see you at Tonkadale.